setting up Windows 10 for privacy. Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. Privacy is one of those sticky issues that keeps rearing its ugly head from time to time. Depending on who you believe, Windows is either exceptionally intrusive or it's actually not that bad. In any case, when you set up Windows, you have some options with respect to your privacy, and I want to go over some of those right now. Let's switch over to our Windows 10 home machine that's already in the process of a Windows setup. Now, of course, one of the first things we need to do before we proceed in the setup process is set up one of our accounts. Microsoft strongly encourages you to use a Microsoft account, and that's what I'm going to show you here. It does give you the most flexibility in terms of account recovery, account access, and more. And it really is the way I think most machines should now be set up. There are some obscure ways to set up a local machine account that I'm not going to cover here in this video, but it is an option if you are particularly concerned about, say, Microsoft's access to your activities and privacy. The account that I'm going to use is my Hotmail account, askleoexample@hotmail.com. Of course, I have to enter the password. And I will now have this account, my Hotmail account, be the login account for this machine. I'm a believer in pins. Pins are nice, they're easy. So I am going to go ahead and use a pin on this machine. Now we get to the privacy settings for this machine. The single most important thing you need to do when it comes to your privacy is not blindly hit accept. What I want to do is talk through some of these items for you a little bit and see which ones you might consider to be important and which ones aren't. For example, location. Do you want it to know where you are? It does add features and functionality to some of the applications that come with Windows. On the other hand, sometimes that location isn't necessary. Diagnostic data. So it's sending information about the websites you browse and how you use apps and features. This one, some people might find intrusive. It's sending information about where you browse and how you use apps. They claim it is done in a not personally identifiable way. If you agree with them, if you believe them, then it may be fine to leave this turned on. On the other hand, if this is of concern to you, then this would be one to potentially turn off. Required diagnostic data is, of course, required. That's part of Windows 10. Tailored experiences. So can they use the information that they've collected to offer tips and ads and recommendations? Well, again, that's kind of up to you. It depends, once again, on how much you trust them. It is not something that will affect your ability to use the system, so I suggest potentially turning that off. Find My Device. This is also a very highly leveraged item when it comes to portable devices. This allows Windows to tell you where you left your device. I recommend leaving this one on as long as you've got location turned on. Inking and typing. This allows them to improve their ability to recognize text when you type it in or when you are writing it in if you've got that kind of an input device. This is another one where you may or may not want Microsoft to see what it is you've been typing or what it is you've been writing. I recommend leaving it on just because I tend to trust them, but if you don't, it's certainly safe to turn off. Advertising ID. Ultimately, that's just a unique number associated with this specific machine that is then shared with advertisers so that they can provide you with ads that are more relevant to what it is you do and look at. If this is something that bothers you, if this is something that concerns you, again, it's also very safe to turn off. Like I said, the most important thing is that you understand what you're agreeing to when you get to this screen. Now that we've set things to be a mix of yeses and nos, I'm going to go ahead and accept the settings. I hope that was helpful. I hope that helps you feel a little bit better about some of the security slash privacy settings that are available on your machine and what you want to set them to. For updates, for links, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/20075. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com.